Good morning all, I am Vinanna Kumar, Assistant Professor of Geology, NG College, Nalgunda. Today's this video lesson for BSc third year students who are studying fifth semester. In fifth semester, that is specific elective subject. In specific elective subject, that is in applied geology. In this applied geology, sericulture and aquaculture. In sericulture, this is the topic today we are going to know about this topic, that is prospects of sericulture in India. What are the developments and what are the issues of in sericulture in India is developing? So today we are going to know about these prospects of sericulture in India detail. Before we are going to know about this, what is the introduction of sericulture, types of silkworms, life cycles of silkworms. Sericulture, that is the stages of production, health hazards in sericulture, sericulture opportunities, and Central Research Institute of India. Thoroughly details, we are going to these steps we are knowing that. Introduction. Sericulture is a Greek word. It is comes from sericos. Sericos means, seri means culture. So these two words brings sericos. This is the sericulture name coming from this Greek word. The rearing of silkworm from production of silk is called as sericulture. In fact, sericulture refers to mass scale rearing of a silk production organism in order to obtain silk. Silk is secreted by silk gland of the silkworm, and it is a fibrous protein in insect organ. Silk fiber consists of two types of protein, namely fibrin and sericin. In India, it is the second largest producer of silk after China. It is also the largest consumer of silk in the world. So, India is coming to second largest producer of silk after China. So India is second place in all over the world. Silk is called as a sericulture industry. Silk refers as a mass of scale rearing of silk producing organism in order to obtain silk. Silk is a protein. It is comes from fibrous protein in insect organ. In silk fiber, it consists of two types of proteins are named that fibrin, that is 80% it is fibrin protein, and sericin protein, it is 20% in silk. So fibrin and sericin is the two main proteins in silk fibers. Sericulture is a farming of rearing of silkworms from the production of raw silk. Sericulture is both an art and a science of raising silkworms and silk production. So sericulture is a arts and science and raising silkworm production. It is two subjects of art and arts and science subject it is mingled in. Amongst specific silkworms, Bombax mori is the most widely used in silkworm fiber silk production of in sericulture. This species is very much used in all over the world. Silk is known as the queen of textile. It is known as the queen of textiles and biosteel. Biosteel, because of its silk strength, it is called as also biosteel. Introduction. In sericulture, it is a agro-based industry. It involves rearing of silkworms for the production of raw silk, which is in the yarn obtaining of cocoons spun by certain species of insects. So rearing of silkworms, it is a production of raw silk and yarn and out of cocoons spun by species of insects. The major activities of sericulture comprise of food plant cultivation and feed the silkworms with the spun silk cocoons and reeling the cocoons and for unwinding the silk filament for value added benefits such as processing and weaving. So there are there is a major activities in sericulture industries that are food plant cultivation, silkworms, spun silkworm cocoons and reeling and unwinding the silk filament and also processing and weaving is the major activities we can see in this silkworm silk producing industries. India is the second largest producer of silk and accounts for nearly 80% of global raw silk production. So India producing all over the world 18%, that is in 18% of silk production. It is the second largest producer of all over the world. Different types of silkworms, we know about that there are five types of silkworms are there. These are the commercial purpose. These are the importance, very important to of different types of species we know. We know about this type of silkworms. There are there is a feed for number of food plants except mulberry. Other varieties of silk are generally termed as non-mulberry. This five types of species, there are feeding of species only mulberry tree leaves that called as mulberry silkworm, and others are feeding with other non-mulberry leaves. So they are called as non-mulberry or vanya species are also called. In India, it is the unique distinction of producing all these commercial varieties. So these are the five varieties in India using for production of silk fiber to produce textile industry. That is mulberry. In mulberry species, they are cultivated of 74.7% in India. Airy species are airy silks are silkworms are cultivated 16.3% and tussar silk worms are 8.4% and oak tussar is 8.2% is cultivated, and muga silk is silkworms are cultivated 0.6. So these are the total raw silk produced by these species. We know about that mulberry silkworm. The mulberry silkworm, commercial silkworm produced by the variety of silk generally refers to mulberry silk. The mulberry silkworm is called as the species Bombax mori. It slowly feeds on the leaves of mulberry plants, and in India, it is the major mulberry silk producing states are Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, and Jammu Kashmir. So these are silk producing states in our India that are the mulberry silk. It is accounts to for 92% of country total mulberry raw silk is produced by this mulberry silkworms. Except the mulberry, the non-mulberry varieties of silks are wild silks known as vanya silks. These are the called as wild silk of mulberry silk, and others are known as vanya silks. Yeah, another one is tussar silkworm. This is the tussar silkworm is generated from the silkworm Anthera melita. This is the species of tussar silkworm Anthera melita. Anthera melita is mainly food plants of it is taken for food plants of like Asan and Arjun. It is less lustrous compared to mulberry silkworm. So shining of compared to my mulberry silkworm, it is quite less of mulberry silkworm. It has it is its own feel and appeals. So it is the main character of this tussar silkworm. Tussar silk is mainly produced in the states of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Orissa, besides Maharashtra, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh. So tussar silk is producing states of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Orissa states, besides Maharashtra, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh also producing this tussar silk. Assassin culture is the mainstay of many tribal community in India. So this tarsar silk are also some tribal communities are producing this type of silk. Munga silk is obtained from semi domesticated multivolatile silkworm. This is the species of Anthera asaminensis is the Munga silkworm. This is the golden yellow silk producing silkworm. So this Munga silk is produced by golden yellow silk. It is the privilege of India and the pride of Assam states. It is produced by the state by state. Munga silk is only in Assam state. Munga culture is specific to the state of Assam and integral part of the tradition and culture of the state. So it is the only integral part of traditional and culture of the Assam state only. The Munga silk is high value production is used in products like saris, makalas and chaddars. So Munga silk is products. This silk products are saris, makalas and chaddars are there. Oak tarsar silkworm. This is the fine variety of tarsar generated by silkworm. This silkworm is species name is Anthera prueli. In India, they paid the natural food plants of oak found in abundance in the sub-Himalayan belt of India. So in this feeds only plants of oak found in abundance in the sub-Himalayan belt of India, covering the states of Manipur, Himalayan, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, and Jammu Kashmir. So these Ocotis silkworms are cultivating that in Manipur, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya and Jammu Kashmir. In China, there is another species is there, Anthera prueli. Anthera prueli is the another species. It is the great product of products of China. Comes from another silkworm. So next, Airy silkworm. Airy silkworm also called as Andy or Errandi silkworm. Airy silk is produced from domestic silkworm that is called Pilosomia rinci. It is feeds main only castor leaves. Agriculture is a household activity practiced mainly from protein rich pupae, a delicacy for the tribals. This silk is used industrially for preparation of chaddars for own use by these tribals. So Airy silkworm is cultivated by only tribal areas of our India. In India, this culture is practiced mainly in the northeastern state and Assam. It is also found in Bihar, West Bengal and Orissa. So this Airy silkworm is preparation of chaddars by own used by the tribals only. In India, this culture is participated mainly in northeastern states and the Assam. Silk production in India. It is domesticated silkworm. It is raised for the purpose of sericulture. Except mulberry, the other non-mulberry variety silks are wild silks known as vanya silks. In India, it is a unique distinction for producing all these commercial varieties of silk. With sericulture activities spread across 52,360 villages. So it is all over the world. It is spreaded by 52,360 villages are cultivating this sericulture industry. The Indian silk industry, it is the only one of the largest generations of employment and foreign exchanges for our country. It brings largest generations of employment and foreign exchanges for our country. In India, is a major mulberry silk producing states are Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, and Jammu Kashmir, which together accounts for 92% of country's total mulberry silk production. So these states are producing 92% of silk producing states are in our India. The silk moth is, what are the sericulture stages of production are there? In production, the silk moth lays eggs, the eggs hatched and larvae feeds on mulberry leaves. When the silkworms are about 25 days old, they are 10,000 times heavier than they hatched. They are now ready to spin a silk cocoon. This silk is produced in two glands in silkworm head and then produced out in a liquid form through a opening called spinnerets. So silk is producing by two silk glands, that are the silk glands comes from head, then forced to the liquid. It is through openings of called spinnerets. It forced out from spinnerets. The silk is solid and it comes to contact with the air, it is become to solidified. Silkworm is spin approximately 1 mile filament, 1 mile of filament, and completely encloses itself in a cocoon about 2 or 3 days. So this will be produced 1 mile of filament, it will be about 2-3 days it will be one of spinning of this cocoon. Due to quality of restrictions, the amount of usable silk is in each cocoon is small. As a result, it will be produced, required to produce 1 kg of silk, that will be remain requires 5,500 silk cocoons are weighing that 1 kg of silk. The silk is obtained from the undamaged cocoon by brushing the cocoon to find the outside the end of the filament. After that steps, we can use the cocoon in boiling. That cocoon will be brushing to outside the end of the to find the outside end of the filament. The silk filament are the wound waved onto a activities undertaken in sericulture. There are some activities are taken in sericulture industry, and there is a mariculture. Mariculture is the cultivation of mulberry plants. The cultivation is mainly taken up in irrigated condition. Silkworm seed production is another activities in sericulture industry. Seed production centers are called by different local names in producing states. The seed is seeds are disease free laying, which are prepared in the centers and supplied to the farming farmers for rearing. So silk production, silkworm seed is another activity. In this silkworm production, they are these seeds are disease free laying, which are prepared for in the centers and supplied to the farmers for rearing. Silkworm rearing. Silkworm rearing is considered to be an agro-based cottage industry. Silkworms are reared in a well-ventilated rearing sheds by shoot rearing methods. Marketing of cocoons. Marketing of cocoons means farmers sell the cocoons in the nearest government cocoon markets. Silk rearing. Silk rearing means the extraction of silk filaments from cocoons by employing a set of processes known as silk reeling. This reeling is done in 3 days, three ways, that are charaka, cottage basins, and multi-ended basins. We are using this reeling of silk. Areas and production. There are some states are rearing this sericulture industry all over the world. Well established in Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, ఒరిస్సా మధ్యప్రదేశ్ మణిపూర్ అండ్ ఉత్తరప్రదేశ్ తమిళనాడు వెస్ట్ బెంగాల్ జమ్మూ అండ్ కాశ్మీర్ అండ్ బీహార్ అమంగ్ దిస్ కర్ణాటక ఇస్ వెరీ టాప్ లిస్టెడ్ ఫాలోస్ బై ద ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ తమిళనాడు వెస్ట్ బెంగాల్ అండ్ జమ్మూ అండ్ కాశ్మీర్ ఇన్ ప్రొడక్షన్ సో ఇన్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ అవర్ ఇండియా కర్ణాటక ఇస్ ద ఫస్ట్ ప్లేస్ టు అప్టైన్ దిస్ సిల్క్ ప్రొడక్షన్ ఇండస్ట్రీ domestic demand the indian silk is silk industry provides mainly to the domestic saree industry which has around the year market across the length and breadth of the country so the silk industry provides for mainly domestic saree industry which is 80% of silk is production for domestic purpose and another 20% is international exports so we are in silkworm industry sericulture that are the 80% of silk producing are for using domestic purpose silk centers in India there are some states are established in silk centers this silk sector's life in culture and indian silk sarees are world famous traditional states are Karnataka Andhra Pradesh Tamil Nadu West Bengal Jammu Kashmir Assam Arunachal Pradesh Bihar Chhattisgarh Himachal Pradesh Jharkhand Kerala Madhya Pradesh Maharashtra Manipur Mizoram Meghalaya Nagaland Orissa Punjab Uttar Pradesh these are the states we are producing traditional states in our market survey the brands are named after the place of origin so in market survey these brands are named for the placing of origin Varanasi is the famous for finest silk sarees and heavy gold silver brocades So, all over India, in Varanasi is the famous for fine silk sarees. These sarees are known as for involved woven motifs of leaves, flowers, fruits, birds, or on soft colored background. And on the other hand, Patola sarees are pride of Gujarat, and they are created in using resist dyeing techniques. In Maharashtra it is known as pitani silk and it is generally comes from kumkum colors in Madhya Pradesh it is famous for chandan and maheshwari and tassar silk sarees in South India it is a producing area for a country famous for heavy and light sarees in Tamil Nadu it is famous for magnificent heavy silk sarees bright colors and gold jari work In Karnataka, it is famous for excellent printed silk. Exports of silk goods from India export natural silk yarn, fabrics, ready-made garments, silk carpets, and silk waste to the US and European countries in large volumes. So, about 20% of silk producing, we are exporting of natural silk yarn and fabrics and ready-made garments, silk carpets, and silk waste to the US and European countries in large volumes. The marvelous designs and area of color combination of silk materials produced in our traditional handlooms and our ability to supply these in small quantities within the country. There are some important silk centers all over our India. These are the silk producing centers in our India where the towns are located in these states. In Andhra Pradesh, Dharmavaram, Venkatagiri, Naripet, and Telangana, Pochampalli, Assam, Sulkanchi, Bihar, Bagalpur, in Gujarat state, Kambe, Jammu and Kashmir, it is in Srinagar, Karnataka, and Bengaluru, Mysore, Ankel, Melkote, and Kolenge, Maharashtra, Patlan, Tamil Nadu, in Kanchipuram, Arani, Salem and Tanjavur in Chhattisgarh, Champa, Chandri, Raghi, Raigar, and Uttar Pradesh, Varanasi, West Bengal is Bishnupur, and Mushirabad is Birbhum. And the brocades and satins of Benares. It instructs designs of Kanchipuram sarees. Patola of Hyderabad and Dupinchin of Bengaluru. Hand knitted carpets of Kashmir are the famous for favorites of European and Americans. India's image is fast changing and growing for the traditional export of dress material to finished apparel exports. So India's image is fast changing and growing in traditional exporter of apparel industry. In recent years, fabrics are dominating, following by ready-made garments. As far as the exports of fabrics is concerned, Bengaluru and Bagalpur are the major exporting centers. Over India, these towns are very much major exporting centers. India silk carpet continues in demand in Europe and US. The exporting earnings from silk are growing steadily over the years. That are the 80 millions of foreign exchange we can developing this silkworm industry. Health hazards in sericulture. Handling of dead worm with bare hand contributes to infection in illness. So when the handling with silkworms, dead silkworms with our bare hands, it will be infectious and illness. Standing almost about 12 to 16 hours per a day, it can lead to problems such as backaches, spine problem, and problem related to vision. And in spinning and vending machines and looms, there is a noise made by these looms where this fabrics in oven, resulting in hearing problems. So health hazards are in sericulture are backaches, spine problem, and vision problem, and also hearing problems are. These are the hazards in sericulture industries. Infrastructure of sericulture in India or in our in Union Government Central Silk Board, CSB, coming under the Ministry of Textiles, Government of India, in Central Agency for the development of sericulture and silk industry. So our Union Government has established a Central Silk Board for research and development in sericulture industry. The main activities of the CSB and R&D uptake the four types of seeds production. Four types are there in seed production network, support the provisional government to implement the field development programs, promotion of the silk at national and international level, and forming and implementing policy actions of the organized development of the industry. These are the main activities of Central Silk Board, that are the programming and promotions of silk national and international level, forming implementation policies, and action for the organized and organized development in the industries. These are the main activities of Central Silk Board. The Central Silk Board undertaken the 300 units and 4,000 employees in different parts of our country. So this activities of Central Silk Board undertaken through 300 units and 4,000 employees in different parts of our country. 800 scientists and 2,500 technical staffs are deployed for specialized areas in different discipline of in the country. So in industry, there are 800 scientists and 2,500 technical staffs are working in this silkworm industry, sericulture industry. So it is a vast development activities are established in this silkworm industry. CSB spends about $60 million per US dollars per annum for development of the sericulture and silk industry. So in our India, silk Central Silk Board are spending this money, 60,000 of US dollars for development and sericulture industry. Developing the sericulture industry. Provisional governments, provisional provincial governments are also developing this sericulture industry. All the provincial governments are having separate departments dealing with the sericulture and the silk industry. Their major responsibilities are implement field development programs, extension, marketing, seed production, and incentives, investments, and among the stakeholders. So there are major responsibilities are taken by provincial governments are implement field development programs and extension, marketing, and seed production are there. The investments by provincial provincial government for the industry that are the 50 million US dollars per annum. So these provincial governments are also spending this money to develop the sericulture industry, and also in developing the sericulture industry, private sector also takes a major role in that developing sericulture industry. The private sector, including non-government organizations, are also playing an important role for the development of the industry. Private investments is witnessed in seed production, post-yarn, and export sectors. So private sector are spending these investments in seed production and post-yarn and post sectors. And there are vast opportunities in sericulture industry of our rural people. In sericulture is being cottage in cottage industry plays an important role in employment and generation and poverty elevation. So this sericulture industry gives an important role in employment generation and poverty elevation also. It is one of the most profitable activity in rural sector, availability of indigenous technology at low cost. So availability of indigenous low technology at low cost, and it is a profitable activity in rural sector area. Regular and quick returns comes from this industry. Large demand and popularity have hand-woven silk in the West. So in our India, there is a large demand and popularity hand-woven silk in the West. Scope of the establishment of larger production units and organized sectors. This silk is woven into cloth and sarees. India is the largest consumer of silk in the world. So India is very much consumer of 80% of silk producing of domesticated in all over the world. Thank you.